What issues do I need to keep in mind when I need to measure a beam coming out of a fiber? There's often confusion when dealing with measurements of a beam coming out of a fiber. The geometry is a little bit different. We have a diverging beam emerging from a small aperture. The parameters used to specify a standard laser beam power measurement, such as diameter of the beam, are not used in quite the same way here. Other parameters are often specified here, such as numerical aperture or fiber core diameter, that are not relevant to standard measurement situations. First, in the way of technical background, a beam of light coming out of a small aperture diverges. This is related to basic wave physics, and in fact this applies to any wave, including even water waves, as well as beams of light emerging from a small aperture, from a small fiber. The angle of divergence is a function of the aperture size. It's often defined by numerical aperture, which is simply the sine of the half angle of the diverging cone of light. The fiber itself is often specified by, among other parameters, its core diameter, which is typically a few tens of micrometers. If one uses our sensor finder program to choose a sensor for measuring a beam of, let's say, some watts of power, but where the sensor finder asks for diameter, one enters the fiber core diameter by mistake, which, remember, is several tens of micrometers, chances are no results will come up. The core diameter of the fiber is not the same as the beam diameter, and choosing a sensor will involve knowing the beam diameter at the sensor surface and not related to the core diameter of the fiber. Coming out of a fiber, it's important to understand that even if the sensor is just a small distance away, the beam may well have expanded enough and reduced its power density enough to enable regular sensors to work okay, even though the sensor finder didn't understand that. In most applications, fibers are terminated by standard connectors such as FC, ST, and others. Ophir offers a range of adapters to allow connecting these terminations to our sensors. Usually, there's a mounting bracket specific to a given sensor type, meaning given mechanical configuration, which may, by the way, include a number of sensor models. And then one or several fiber connectors can be connected to this bracket, depending on the specific details. For some sensors, there's no need for a bracket. Details are given in our catalog and on the website. Distance is built into the mechanical configuration of these fiber adapters. This means that normally, by the time the beam reaches the sensor surface, it has expanded enough, just as I mentioned earlier, and damage issues are thus avoided. Note, however, this is not always a certainty. For example, when using a sensor from the PD300 series photodiode-based sensors, especially with filter in, the distance from the fiber tip to the sensor surface to the filter surface could be quite small. A power level that's well within the specification limits of the sensor could still sometimes result in a power density on the sensor's filter that's too high, and the result could be damage to the filter. In most cases, as we noted, this is not a concern, but in situations where any one parameter seems like it's going to be near a limit, a quick sanity check is a good idea.